Hey guys, this is Austin. We have been doing some major server upgrades here at the office. First steps toward that, of course, we did the Stornator project a little while ago, but Synology reached out and they wanted to sponsor a little something special.
Yeah, so this is their DS1019 Plus. For something like this, because it's easy to actually configure this to
this
have
so much easier. Yeah.
Online access for, we want to throw things like finished video files, thumbnails, like stuff that, you know, is crucial for us uploading onto YouTube, but say if something goes wrong and we're not in the office, we can actually access this from anywhere and grab those files and do what we have to do.
So we've actually both used Synology products in the past. I actually have one of their super secure ones that's like fireproof and waterproof in my house. I know you have...
I have the DS416 Play. And I use that more for just media consumption. I have a Plex server running on it. I have all my music and movies. And I mean, I'm not much of a network geek at all, but it was super easy for me to set up.
These things are the simplest that they get. So with the Synology NAS, what we're able to do is have all kinds of files, not just videos, but primarily that's what we're going to be using it for, available anywhere, anytime, as long as we have a decent internet connection. The first thing we actually need to do is get this set up. You've got it just plugged in here, but we don't have the drives in it yet.
Seagate actually provided these for us. These are their Ironwolf NAS drives. They gave us 3 2-terabyte drives. So the DS1019 Plus has 5 bays in it, and right now, obviously, we're using 3 drives.
Mostly just a test, though.
So I do
like these Ironwolf drives, but with 2 terabytes each, this is much more for a smaller project. Now, in theory, with 5 drives, I mean, you could load this thing up with, probably 50 terabytes or so if you get some of the like 10 terabyte hard drives or something.
Yeah, if you really want to. And on top of that, if you want to have faster cache, on the bottom here, there are M.2 slots. So you can actually, you know, put drives in there that'll help speed things up a little more.
So there are, of course, different ways of using the Synology NAS. So one of which is just over your local network, right? So if you have everyone plugged in via Ethernet, and we'll test that in a second, that all works. But if you're out and about, you know, you're wanting to connect via Wi-Fi or LTE or something, it still does work. But when you have those SSDs, it definitely does help to speed things up when you do have the caching set up.
Yeah, it's cool that this is properly toolless too, because it just makes it so easy to just hot swap these if you really want to.
Yeah.
It's not super, super foolproof, but there are plastic keys that kind of lock the drives in place. So if you want like a light level of security, so no one just randomly snatches your drives, you can just quickly lock them in.
Do you have a problem with people randomly snatching your drives?
It happens from time to time. No, it doesn't.
Boom, we are up and running.
Yep.
So it actually is basically like a full interface that you can use inside the browser.
So to put it simply, a NAS is like an external hard drive that's on your network that can be accessed by any of the devices on the network.
Yeah.
So
right now I'm connected via Ethernet, and all I need to do is literally just drag and drop a file in here if I actually open up the correct one. And yeah, I mean, look at, we're at 100, 112, 113 megabytes per second. So if you want to get in, you can actually do a lot of things to really kind of customize the way the software works, permissions, all that kind of stuff. But the main thing is that it's hidden behind your password, right?
Right.
So as long as you don't give someone your username or password, they won't be able to get in and access your files.
Right.
And of course, you don't have to set it up the way that we are. If you just want to keep it on your local network, by all means, go ahead. But because the main purpose of this is so we can pull our files down from anywhere, that is a huge advantage. You really sort of, the way we're thinking about this, as a replacement for cloud services. Right? Because,
right,
of course, you could say upload to any number of various cloud services, but not only do you have to pay for those monthly, but on top of that, you really don't own your data. With this, we have full control over whatever we want to do, change permissions, we can give specific people logins or whatever.
Yeah.
And we don't have to pay, you know, $20, $30 a month for whatever we need to actually keep saved.
Yeah, and the other thing too is that, like, I mean, we have 6 terabytes in here, and if you actually price out, you know, how much those services cost a month and how much space you get.
Oh yeah, it gets expensive. Oh,
yeah.
Especially if we load it up with like 30, 40 terabytes, which is what this will probably end up being.
Right.
This is gonna be nice.
So we actually have the remote access set up where right now my iPad's on LTE and I can see the console where you can control everything. It's the same screen that he has up here.
It's impressive that it works pretty well on iOS.
Yeah, and then also what I can do is they have an app that's kind of simplified where you can just see the straight up folders and files.
That's much easier when you're on iOS, because with that you can just like say download the file or transfer or throw it wherever you want. Right,
and so what I can do is actually play that same mystery tech that he was playing, and it'll actually open up automatically on VLC,
right,
or even on its own app, you can choose which one.
I mean, I can say from my side, when I'm actually on the local network, it plays
guys,
basically immediately. So I think the main idea here is that you can use this for a ton of different aspects. For us,
right,
I think we're going to be downloading videos from it while we're on the go, and then when we're actually at, you know, at the office or whatever, we can very easily use the local network to throw files back and forth to it.
Right.
You can also very easily use this for backups, and on top of that, one of the nice things is that because you can add as many drives as you can fit into the bays, you can also expand the storage, because it does,
right,
take advantage of RAID by default. default.
Yeah, you can pretty much have one of the drives go down and replace it and be totally
You don't lose any data.
And you don't lose any data.
Hard drives can die, you know, especially when you have them running for long periods of time. So it's nice to have some redundancy, because obviously no backup is as good as a single failed hard drive. Like, nah, man, that's not.
Right.
That's not it.
I'm actually dealing with a lot of 1080 files, not 4K files.
You don't need to download them. You can just stream them straight up.
This is streaming right now. This is not downloaded to my iPad, and it's running off LTE, and it
That's
looks
awesome.
Pretty smooth.
So unlike our very expensive server solution, this is a much better setup for what we're actually going to be doing with it, which of course is just pulling down files while we're on the go, no matter where we are. Now, of course, if you want 100 terabytes, this is probably not the unit for you. But if you talk about like 10, 15 terabyte, 20, like in the normal realm of not 8K raw footage that is being uploaded every day, then this is very much a better solution. Yeah. And in fact, we actually have one to give away, don't we?
We do. It's not this exact one, but we do have
a...
Yeah, this one's our baby. So it's the DS218 Plus, which is their two-bay system, and Seagate's throwing in two terabyte drives, so that's 4 terabytes total of storage. And yeah, that should pretty much offer the same amount of stuff that's in here, like software-wise. Why are you laughing?
I like it when you do the giveaways.
Why?
It sounds so much more legit. With your two terabyte hard drives for free! Just pay postage and shipping and handling directly to Kimbalito.
No, they're actually doing that too.
Okay, cool. I was waiting for your angle of just give me a little bit of extra Mystery Tech money.
Oh, well, I mean, I can always use Mystery Tech.
So since Ken didn't plan out the giveaway, we're going to make this very simple. All you do is go follow us on Twitter at Austin@Duncan as well as at Synology, and just tweet us what you want to do if you actually win the 218 Plus. In 2 weeks, we will randomly choose a tweet and you will be gifted with a wonderful new Synology NAS. Did you do the Vanna White? You did do the Vanna White. Thank you very much. And of course, if you guys want to check out this guy, the link will be in the description. And stay tuned. We're definitely going to be doing a lot more server and networking fun videos soon. Does that sound fun?
Yeah.
Actually, it doesn't sound fun.
Well, because you're going to be doing it. And I'll just sit there and laugh while you mess things up.